Something in your eyes makes me wanna lose myself. Makes me wanna lose myself. There's something in your voice that makes my heart beat fast. Hope this feeling lasts the rest of my life. If you
this school was originally built in 1939. It was originally a wooden schoolhouse. It was located where the parking lot is now. We had two Sisters of Mercy, and Father Conklin was the pastor at the time. And a very small school. We had grades 1 through 8. Those two nuns taught all of those grades. Later, in 1958, we were busting at the seams and decided we needed to build a bigger school, and some very forward-thinking parents came together and built the school that we're currently adjoined to. And so we now have 445 children. So we've come a long way since 1939.
It's a neat conversation for our kids to be able to talk to their grandparents and to have gone, you know, to the same school. And so I think that creates a natural link between them. So it's gone, you know, back through our family for generations.
I guess as pastor, I'm looking at the total context and rationale for a Catholic school. And it is that wonderful means by which community is built, by which the gospel is proclaimed, and which we form young minds, not only to take an active part in this community, but also in our world.
I just see the community of families looking out for each other is a big difference to me. The standards we set for our children with in regards to what we want them to do in the future, as far as the community service, as far as character building, I think that Blessed Sacrament provides those things for our children.
I just feel like this is my home away from home.
It's a really great experience to walk into the school, and no matter who you encounter, from the principal to teachers to the kids to the staff, everybody is friendly, and everybody's, you know, seems to truly care about each other.
Honestly, in everyone's case, we're just one big family.
Well, it's just like home, you know, everybody, and it's like a family, and you just feel like you belong.
I find and I feel like it's more of a home than it is an institution. I think it's very warm, very welcoming, very loving, and we were absolutely embraced coming from another school, and we've continued to feel like this was the absolute best choice for our children. I think so far it's the best choice I've ever made for them.
We have something called families, and
tell me about that.
We have like a teacher, and we sometimes call her mom, and we have other kids in our group. Like, I have 20 other kids, and they're like our brother and sister, and we do fun activities, and sometimes we watch movies with them.
It has a family atmosphere, and Taylor really enjoys coming here. I mean, people are very warm. And I also had a Catholic school background, so it meant a lot for me to have the same type of education for her.
Everybody genuinely cares what's happening to your child and her life and making her a better person, making her a person to go out and function in the world.
Everyone is so passionate about this school. Absolutely, you know, they want the best. It's not about the building, it's about the people. That is the whole thing. The Blessed Sacrament is unique.
I think it's just balance. I mean, I think that, you know, the kids are getting an overall experience, both academics, athletics, but also just their personal relationships with kids from a variety of backgrounds, which is kind of a nice thing.
I wasn't committed to any school when we put Sophie in kindergarten. We toured probably 3 or 4 public schools and a couple other private schools, and it just seemed like every conversation we had, we were comparing it back to Blessed Sacrament, and so it kind of hit home that, you know, that was the highest standard for us.
I've always thought students, if you raise the bar, they will rise to that level. The higher the bar, the harder they'll try, and I think that is throughout our entire curriculum that you'll see that. We are constantly assessing and our students to make sure that they are performing. If there's a group of students or a student that's having difficulty, we have plans in place for remediation. There are special SST programs for those students with defined learning disabilities. And we work together as a group to help each child reach their academic potential.
I think it's a tough place, but a good tough place. You know, we are maybe a little weird. We always want our kid to have the tougher teacher, you know, the teacher that's going to maybe push them a little harder. And, you know, this year they just raised the standards for National Junior Honor Society from an 86 to a 90. And that made me happy, you know, when they did that last year, because I thought, you know, I mean, just makes them push a little harder.
The teachers are amazingly warm, funny. They're like an extended family for the children. I'm there often taking pictures. Never have I walked in where I didn't want to stay.
We don't want mediocre. Blessed Sacrament's not about mediocre. We're about pushing them to do the best that they can do.
Ms. Brown has been here for a very long time. Ms. Willoughby has been here for a long time. And they're both outstanding. They know what they're doing. They're very good with the kids. And they also make you understand that we mean business.
I don't know if my child, you know, if any of them are going to want to go to a Harvard or a local college, but I want them to have as many choices. And I think the way Blessed Sacrament is structured, especially with like the math program, you know, they had the higher level math, the math team, and I think they push them and they have to do a lot of writing and, you know, various classes. So, you know, that was what for us made the decision to make the move. And we've been thrilled.
Friends and colleagues who have younger kids are fretful. I mean, that they may not be able to get their child in the Blessed Sacrament. And there's just, you know, there's only one Blessed Sacrament. The teachers here, the parents here, even the students themselves are the best advertisement. They're wonderful.
We continue to strive to improve ourselves. We don't stay still. You can't stay still. If you stay still, you're going to be falling back. You have to keep moving. And we analyze what we're doing well, and we do more of it. We look at what we don't do so well, and we make sure that we shore that up.
I think Blessed Sacrament has done a wonderful job in fostering development of the whole student through a clear value and expectations of the student. Again, I think the outside curriculum of getting the students involved in outside activities, community service, the awareness of our community is great leadership in the future.
From a school standpoint, mm-hmm. I think the school almost reflects a partnership with the parents. There is an understanding that they're providing support in terms of faith and education, But ultimately, it's the parents' responsibility to drive that home. And so you feel like you're working with somebody. You're not turning your child over to be mm-hmm. educated mm-hmm. and to be taught. You are sharing your child throughout the day so that you can make that child a better person mm-hmm. in the end.
Nothing makes me more happier than to have a student come back in after 5-6 years and go, thank you so much for what Blessed Sacrament has done for me. I wouldn't be here today without you. And that's why we believe.
Our faith is what holds us together. Our faith is central to everything that we do. It is in our academics. It is in our day-to-day life. It is most important that we teach children to treat each other with respect, with kindness, and we're not a private school. We are a Catholic school because God is in the center of everything that we do.
The value of an education is not just academic. So much of it has to do with your spiritual beliefs, with your understanding of God, with your value system, with trying to be the best person you can be, because it's what you're supposed to do.
And they're teaching them to be the best person they can be. They don't have to be the same person as everybody else. They just need to be the best person they can be and treat everybody in the world with respect and try to make the world a better place. And I just don't know if you have enough of that anymore.
And they have made each stage of their spiritual growth very important. They've had, they'll have classes based around it. They'll have projects based around it. They have outings, little field trips before. They really prepare the student for each stage. And confirmation, she's there. She's ready. And I feel great about it.
The fact that our daughter, I hear her sometimes say things and I stop and I go, okay, that's exactly why we wanted a Catholic education. I did, because she's being taught at a very early age the lessons of the Bible and the ways of the Lord, and that to me is just the rock. That is it for me.
I certainly believe that what we do in terms of faith is certainly very important, because it permeates everything else that we do as a school. Mathematics, science, reading, religion, everything. So from that perspective, it's a true gift.